Good morning.
Amen.
Madunggan ra ba ko?
Amen.
Madunggan ra? Amen. Ara na madunggan ra no. Okay. Glory to God for this opportunity and privilege nga God allowed me without an accident but a reason and a purpose and ako diri karon because God led me to do so. Ang Ginoo nagtawag na ako dire para maghatag siya og mensahe kanato. So high pressure kay kung barug aning dapita because when mag-speak si Daddy Mark, I called him Daddy Mark. Nagyud siya ay pwede na mic, no?
You're okay, just need to turn it down.
Ah, okay. Duhagin sila mag-preach dire si Daddy Mark and the GM. So ako rin usa diri og speaker on. And I will speak in vernacular way. Sometimes I will speak in English and sometimes in Bisaya para magsinabtanay ra kita, no? Because my desire is to deliver the message of the Lord nga masabtan gyud nato.
Amen.
So ganina siguro na-introduce na ko sa speaker ganina. I am Brother Eric and some called me Pastor Eric. And one of the things that nung nag-stay ko sa Mindanao because the Lord planted me the burden and the passion for Mindanao.
Amen.
Especially for the young people and for the churches in Mindanao. That is why naku diri karon and I do believe there are many things that had happened to us, especially when pandemic strike, no? And I am one of them that was being persecuted of my belief that I will not get the vaccine. And some people did not understand my decision because when I decide something, kung decision ko sa kong kagalingon, I always consult God.
Amen.
I always ask the Holy Spirit to guide me. And there's no conviction to me to take that vaccine. That is why they persecuted me. But the sad thing is, they persecuted me inside my colleague in the ministry. But I thank the Lord for the opening doors and opportunity that the Lord is opening me up. So praise God for that, no? Thank you. So this morning, when Daddy Mark asked me to preach, and he asked me, Pastor, can you preach in our worship service this Saturday? So there is an excitement and the joy that is within my heart because I believe the Lord is opening a door. Nag-abri ang Ginoong opportunity because serving the Lord is the greatest opportunity and privilege.
Amen.
That we had.
Amen.
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 Amen. So as I observed the worship service this morning, before we will pray, I will not introduce totally myself, but just call me Brother Eric, Pastor Eric. I'm 35 years old young. I'm still single, but not available. I am committed to someone that I'm praying for. And I'm so blessed by the Lord, but because I am praying for 7 years at that woman that I am engaged with, and the Lord has answered my prayer for so long, and that is why I'm here today, because so much grace and favor that God has given to me. Amen?
Amen.
And I do believe also, if na ako excitement, na mo excitement pod. Amen?
Amen?
Because the Lord is speaking to us, is a living God. Buhi ang Diyos, nga mag-istorya ka na to, pinagi sa iyong pulong. Amen?
Amen.
And if you are a genuine believer, you should have that joy.
Amen.
Because the Holy Spirit is in you. That is one of the fruit of the Holy Spirit. Amen?
Amen.
Since I observe the service, okay, I am so blessed by the Lord for the message of the prayer about sakto si GM. I would connect to the message of GM ganina nga when he was traveling in Region 10, when he crossed over to region 11, he felt more the presence of the Lord in this region. Hallelujah. And I asked the Lord, the same conviction that GM that I had, because you know what had happened in Misamis Occidental right now? They are welcoming the idols. They were welcoming the Santo Niño in Cebu. That is an idol. Uh-oh. And the Lord was not blessed in that. And the presence of once the Lord is had masuko ang Ginoo sa mga idols, and the presence of the Lord will depart on that place. That is why since since December in Oroqueta, the welcome the Brahin sa Simula. That is why the Lord bring judgment in our place. So I thank the Lord for, I just want to connect that conviction that the Lord has given to GM, and praise the Lord for for preserving the region 10, especially Sambuanga del Norte, because I believe God will work in this place. Amen!
Amen.
Praise be. A clap offering to God. Kung ikaw igsoon, kabahin ka na sa buluhaton sa Ginoo, dili aksidente nga na kakaron.
Amen.
Because the Lord has a reason and a purpose in your life.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So, nindot kayo, maigsoon, because whether we like it or not, Jesus will coming soon. We have church, we will prepare. Amen. Amen ba? Nawa pa diha? Amen ba?
Amen.
Okay. So, before we will go to prayer, let me remind you a part of scriptures in Revelation that word kana nga pulong may appear na once in the book of Revelation, the word holy, holy, holy. The supremacy of the holiness of God. Let me remind you, when you are worshiping the Lord, we are worshiping a holy God. Yes. That is why sa prayer na to ganina, na give a praise sa Ginoo for surrendering, for purification. I asked the Lord when I traveled from Plaridel to Dipolo for 1.5 hours, Lord, ayaw pa ulan na, kay mabasa ko. So miabot ko 7 o'clock in the morning as I have texted to Daddy, maybe 7 a.m. I will arrive. And the Lord, kapalo kami ulan. Ulan siya. Ibalo ba mo sa significance sa tubig in the scriptures? Purification.
Amen.
It is used for purification, for cleansing.
Amen.
Amen. And I do believe the Lord will purify us because the Lord that we are worshiping today is a holy God. Amen.
Amen.
He is a holy God. And we will respect and honor His holy name.
Amen.
Amen. So ako lang gi-connect ang mga revelations sa Ginoo ganina, and so much passion and desire nga gihatag sa Ginoo sa mga tao in Dapita, and I am so blessed by the Lord nga gihatag sa mga tao during Dapita. So I'm so excited to deliver His message, but before that we will ask the Lord and we will pray for the Lord as we continue to deliver His message. Let us bow down. Let us acknowledge the presence of the Lord. Let us pray and ask the Lord. Father in heaven, hallowed be your name, O God. We enter in your holiness, O God, through the blood of the Lamb, through the blood of Jesus. Lord, thank you for the great opportunity and privilege in honoring you and worshiping you, O God. Lord, salamat. Salamat, Holy Spirit, nga ikaw magapanglihok ka namo karon. I submit before you, O God, through your word, O God, that your word is living and active. Abuhi imong pulong, Ginoo. Imong pulong makigistorya ka namo. Imong pulong maghatag ka namo revelation. Imong pulong mag-encourage ka namo, mag-review ka namo, mag-tudlo ka namo. Your word, we need your word, O God. Lord, salamat kayo, Ginoo. Because the Holy Spirit will move by the truth of your word, O God. Lord, we submit everything to you, O God. Hide me, O Father God. with humble and humility heart, O God. Lord, nga dili makita ako, Ginoo, kung dili makita si Kristo sa akong kinabuhi, Ginoo, as you have sent to your people, O God. Lord, salamat kaayo that you anoint me, O God, as you anoint your people in this place, O God. Anoint their heart and mind, O Father God, that they will ready to receive your message, O God, with a joyful heart, O God. Thank you, Lord. We submit everything to you, O God, because apart from you, we can do nothing, O God. With a humble heart, we submit everything to you, O God, that you will accomplish today, O God. We give you honor and glory and praises and thanksgiving, Lord. In the mighty name of your Son, Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. So the message that I have prepared this morning, nag-ampo gyud ko sa Ginoo, nangayo ko sa Ginoo before Sunday. Nag-meet me ni Brother Mark and ni Daddy Mark and the GM. The opportunity came in. Niluhod ko sa Ginoo, Lord, what is your message that I will bring to your people in that place, Ginoo? So, at that time, there was an event that took place in Plaridel, the blast of trumpet, if you are familiar with that. So, it is an evangelistic movement, and we spend in the prayer mountain, and I will go there, and kita mga Kristohanon good, ganahan gud kita anong pulong sa Ginoo. We are so excited. So, I go to the prayer mountain, and ask the Lord, and somehow, God gave me this word, nga, iyang ipaabot kanato pinagi sa akong kinabuhi. Please turn with me. Mutana lang ko sa inyo. Kinsa sa inyo karon diri nag-attend for the first time? Please raise your right hand. First time you naka-attend. Wala ba? Wala. Wala tayo bisita karon. Oh na. Praise God for the brothers and sisters, no? Atong paka na Ginoo. Sa kinabuhi, no? Okay. How many of you here nga naka-attend na for 1 to 3 months? Naka-attend na diri for that 1 to 3 months. Sa fellowship. Nabadre? Nabadre? Mga 1 to 3 months. Kanang, please raise your right hand. Ay, kaulaw. O, oh, na. Pagpaka na itong Ginoo, no? And how many of you here nga naka-attend na more than 3 months? Please raise your right hand. Okay, praise the Lord. Ako nang gikuan because gisorbi lang na ako. And nalang ko'y pangutana pa ko before I will read the scripture. How many of you here nga na'y cellphone? Raise your right hand. Tanan ba? Tanan, na ano? Question again. How many are you here nga na'y kaugalingan nga Bible? Wow! Praise the Lord for that! Praise the Lord. You know what? I am so blessed with this congregation because nakita na ko, if you have your Bible, please get the Word of God.
Amen.
Because we need this. Because this is our spiritual food.
Amen.
Okay? Amen. Wala ang pulong sa Ginoo. Wala ang mahimo nga kahimuan sa Ginoo. If you have your Bible with you are so blessed. Nagidala ni mo. Do not rely on the Bible. Yes, na may Bible sa cellphone. Na may Bible. Yes, I have a lot of Bible, but I always bring my Bible. Amen. Because diha ko na in love pag-ayo sa pulong sa Ginoo.
Hallelujah.
And the reason why God called me, itawag ko sa Ginoo sa wala damha. Because I don't have this passion and calling before. Gusto lang na ko, nominal Christian, but the Lord called me in the ministry as pastors. And I said to the Lord, yes, Lord, I will go. So, ako karon gyud as testimony that I am obeying the will of the Lord.
Amen.
If you have your Bible with you, please turn with me to the book of Philippians, chapter 2. I've been reading from verse 1 to 11. Okay? Okay. Nga nabata diha. Ug naa mga Bisaya inyo ha, dungan lang ta sa pagbasa because I'll be reading in the NIV version, okay? Okay. As we respect the word of God, may I request everyone to stand?
Amen.
Pagtahod nato sa pulong sa Ginoo, gihangyo na ko ang tanan sa pagpanindog. Amen. Okay. Akong basahon ang pulong sa Ginoo sa Philippians chapter 2, verse 1 to 11. Nag-ingon siya. Ang title sa perikopi, Imitating Christ's Humility. Nag-ingon siya sa verse 1, "Therefore, if you have any encouragement from being united with Christ, if any comfort from His love, if any common sharing in spirit, if in tenderness and compassion, then make joy complete by being like-minded, having the same love, being one in spirit and one in mind. Do nothing out of selfish ambition. Value others above yourself. Do not looking to your own interest, but each of you to interest to other." Verse 5, "In relationship with one another, having the same mindsets as Christ Jesus." Verse 6, nag-ingon, "Who being in very nature God, did not consider equality with God something to be used to his own advantage. Rather, he made himself nothing by taking the very nature of a servant, being made in human likeness, and being found in the appearance of man. He humbled himself by becoming obedient to death, even death on the cross." Wow. "Therefore, God exalted him to the highest place and gave him the name that is above every name, that the name of Jesus, every knee will bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue will acknowledge that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Amen." Amen. Hallelujah. Makapanglingkod ang tanan. Wow. Are you amazed with the Word of God?
Yes.
Gibasa pa lang natong daan to. Lailain tag translation ay Bisaya, samot tag Bisaya, lami kay paminahon. But I am using my NIV version. I have a lot of Bibles, but I am using this. So I have ESV, NASB, a lot of translation, but I'm using this. And one of the things, as I have used this, I have read this Bible, this particular passage many times. Matana ko sa inyo, how many of you here nga nabasa ninyo ang tibuok Bible? Na? Siguro gamay lang, no? Siguro some of you have already read from the Old Testament to the New Testament. Brothers and sisters, I encourage you to spend time to read the Bible and the whole Bible from Old Testament to New Testament, because you will discover more and more of God. Muna nga, gidikasig ko muna ako nga paggahin nyo panahon o encouragement sa iyong kagalingon, mahatag mo nga goal karon. This year, I will read the whole scripture from the Old Testament to the New Testament.
Amen.
Dili lang na tubasahon. We need to study. We need to meditate the Word of God.
Amen.
Amen? So, some of you, I read the Bible 7 times. The whole Bible, I read the 7 times. So, grabe. But, grabe ang Ginoo. Every time I would read the Bible, grabe ang revelation. Amaze ko sa Ginoo how His Word is so living.
Hallelujah.
Amen? The message nga akong paabot sa inyo karon, nag-center gina sa statement ganina nga, every time confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of the Father.
Amen.
Because the theme of my sermon this morning, I've entitled my message this morning, Jesus is Lord. Mga tanak ko, na tinuod bagyod nga si Jesus Kristo Ginoo sa inyong kinabuhi.
Amen.
Amen. Okay. Mabawa na ito na. We will check that confession that you had is tinuod. Because dili lang taman sa itong paglitok na si Jesus is Lord, but in all aspects sa itong kinabuhi, kinahanglan siya nga Ginoo.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen?
Muna'y gusto sa Ginoo. I have an author, I have read this article, nag-ingon siya, "If you have no interest in a holy God now, why we think we ought to be with Him for eternity?"
Correct.
If wala tayong interest sa pulong sa Ginoo, And then, nganong nagtinguha man kamo ato sa langit.
Hallelujah.
No? Because one of the manifestation nga ikaw tinuod nga alagad ug anak sa Ginoo na kay desire or passion sa mga langit ng nabutang.
Amen.
Diya sa pagtuunat sa pulong sa Ginoo, sa pag-worship, sa pag-ampo. Amen. How many times of you pray out in one day? How many times you pray? Pastor, I pray 3 times a day. Pamahaw, panayodo, panayapon, good. But you know what? The prayer that God desires is katong giingon ganina, a passionate, a surrendered prayer. Karabitong, you have nothing, everything left to you, and you bow down to the Lord. Lord, kay balab ba mo, usay sa itong mga prayer, dili may imposible. Pero kay balab mo, unsa gi-honored sa Ginoo mga prayer, is ka naman pag-ampo nga imposible. Why? Because if you afraid in impossible things, things will happen. Diha mo panglihok ang Ginoo. Sabi mong God, ang atong paglantaw sa Ginoo is this. Kamay ra kayo. Remember, ang tibuok kalibutan. The whole universe is on His hand.
Amen, amen.
But, tanawon na to, may gusto, grabe, kayo ang Ginoo. So, if you read this particular passage in Ephesians, let me give you a small historical background in this passage. Gamay nga background ani. Paul writing this letter to the church of Ephesians, like the church of the prologue. Right? Kaya ba mo? When Paul writing this message, he was on prison. He was in house arrest. Kaya ba mo? Sa una, kung prison ka sa una, og house arrest, ikaw magbayad sa balay, and you will provide your needs. The kind of situation that Paul that had dili, basta-basta. And yet, the Lord, the passion that the Lord provide everything that He needs. And wala na himong babag ni Paul nga padayon siya pa pangalagad sa Ginoo.
Amen.
Usay gani ma-bless kay ko nga kana nabito yung mga disabled person na impairment sa iyang sila ang mga sa ila ang lawas, but they have the passion to serve the Lord. Nick Mojisik, remember? Evangelist that you no hands, no feet, but he still managed to deliver the message of the Lord. Napo si Kuya ganina, grabe the passion sa iyang heart despite of his situation, wala nakababang mga lagad sa sa Ginoo.
Amen.
Ona tong hinumduman kanunay ang pagpangalagad sa Ginoo. You are investing your life for eternity.
Amen.
Ug walay makaagaw ni ana. Amen. And that is the situation of Paul as he was writing this word. Because nakita man gud ni Apostle Pablo, he heard the message nga daghan kay mga Kristohanon sa Philippians nga gahinahinay na palayo sa Ginoo. Because during at that time, the church of Philippians is very prosperous. But gipasalamatan gihapon ni Apostle Pablo because of their generosity to extend their love gift, because gigamit ang sa Ginoo ang church of Philippians to provide the needs of Apostle Paul through their love gift and offering para makasurvive si Paul. Kaya mamatay mo si Paul sa situation niya kay saon niya pagbayad sa renta, huwag siya trabaho. Ipriso pa siya. Because, no? You see? The Lord works. Ang Ginoo namuhat yun. And then, this particular message, when he heard the sermon, he thanked Epaphroditus at that time for visiting him and giving him that love gift and offering. And then, nadunggan niya ang balita. Sa balita si Epaphroditus, ang mga Kristohanon sa Pilipos naghinahinay pala. You know what? Kaya ba lumabog unsay hinungdan nga nang layo ang mga Kristohanon? Because sometimes we need to be careful with this. Okay? There are a lot of Christians who have been deceived by the word. Okay? Because ang kalibutan, grabe mo tintal. You know what? Grabe kayo ang kalibutan mo tintal. During that time, naghinahinay o palayo ang mga believers sa Philippians, nawala ilang passion and zeal in serving the Lord because they are enjoying the prosperity of that area. And the Lord is never been the number one priority sa ilang kinabuhi.
Yeah.
Nga nahimo na lang sila na compromiser. And the Lord used Apostle Paul to deliver this letter to them as a rebuke and an encouragement for them to continue your passion and zeal for the Lord. Nigipakita niya rito through this letter si Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Because, you know what? Kabalaba mo, ang gipromote sa kalibutan is this materialism, the spirit of materialism. And sometimes Christian is dali kay mga lingla ana. Amen ba? Sa una, namin mga members sa una, Pastor, pray for me. Pray for me that I will bless this. Yes, yan puan. The Lord bless his business. Pag guman, gi-bless na business niya, nawala na. Naibaboy, gibuhi, Pastor. Ano sa yung Thanksgiving, ani? Ang pinakagamay may gihatag. Gikwa kita, tambok-tambok mo ni ani. Hello? Ang worship, ang word nga worship is not limited on your giving financially, but in all aspects sa iyong kinabuhi.
Hallelujah!
Dili taing ana. Ma-enjoy nato ang blessing sa Ginoo materially, and we will enjoy more of the blesser. Amen?
Amen.
Dili ta mag-focus sa blessing, kung dili mag-focus ta sa blesser.
Amen.
Why? Because we are focusing on the blessing, mahubsan ka. Dito ka sa blesser. That is the struggle of the Church of Philippians. So focus kita sa kalibutan. You know what? In sad reality, because of the advent of technology, the internet, grabe kayo ang hatak sa kaaway. You know what? Because in the last days, if you will study eschatology, wickedness will increase. The struggle, ang Church of Philippians, the pride of life, what is pleasing to their eyes, the lust of flesh. Diba? Muna yung mga ginapromote karon sa kalibutan? Ang norms gikuhan sa kalibutan? Especially young people. You are aspiring to get a degree? Yes. Sakto mo na. But daghan ko mga young people na encounter. Pastor, pray for my study. Yes, we will pray for your study. Pagkahuman. Habalo? Kanuna yung pahinunduman. Always been partners ang Ginoo sa inyong pag-study. After humapag-study nyo, makita mong trabaho. Pero daghan, nangawala na. Pag gumawa na sa ilang kurso, nakatrabaho na, wala na sa simbahan. And wala na sila gani, passion to help for the church. Is that what God desired to you? Hinahanglan mga young people, this, if you are aspiring to fulfill your future in your career right now, always set in your mind, na partners niyo ang Ginoo. Number one priority niyo ang Ginoo.
Amen.
Do not set aside that. Amen?
Amen.
So muna ang struggle nga na-encounter the Church of Philippians, and Paul reminded the church to the inspiration of the Holy Spirit. You need Jesus Christ is Lord sa inyong kinabuhi. Muna yung message. Muna ang gidad-on ako nga message karon is Jesus Christ is Lord. Simple as that. We need to understand that phrase, Jesus Christ is Lord.
Amen.
Ato nang sabton pag-ayo, itong gibasa gani-ganina na pananginan kay nato ta. Grabe kaayo, imagine. The King of Kings and the Lord of Lords stepped down from heaven to earth, formed in a human likeness, the purpose and plan for redemption. Imagine the kind of passion and love nga gi-extend sa Ginoo sa tuha. Imagine, kabalo ba mo? Dili biya. Kabalo mo? Muna akong encourage sa inyo. Dili obligado ang Ginoo nga luwasunta with the full of men. God is not obligated to save us. But because of His mercy, His love for us, He sent His only Son to die for us.
Amen.
So grabe kayong opportunity and privilege gihatag sa Ginoo sa atoa. Amen?
Amen.
Pakpaka na itong Ginoo na. We are so blessed by that. Daghang kayong tao karon nag-enjoy sa kalibutan. But na, wala sila kahibalo. Kahibalo na yung sa quotation. The greatest tragedy in life ni Miles Monroe, if you read it. The greatest tragedy in life is not death. But the greatest tragedy in life is a life without purpose.
Correct.
Daghang tao karon sa kalibutan, wa sila kay balog unsay purpose nila. Abi nila ang purpose nila tama sa kalibutan. If their purpose tama sa kalibutan, dire ra po sila sa kalibutan gyud. The only thing that you would know your real purpose if you encounter the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And you can agree. And you need to be real diha sa papangalagan sa Ginoo. This is not a playing ground.
Amen.
Young people, I would always remind this to the young people. Di lang mga young people, even for the church members. Ayaw, himo ang ministry nga himo ang dula-dulaan. Himo ang ministry, seryoso ha, kaya katawaw, galwas na to, seryoso nga Ginoo, nga naghatag siyang kinabuhi sa cross para ikaw ako, luwason niya.
Amen.
Iyang dugong yung gihatag ka na to, dili, sa mabahiran may on. And you need to be serious with your calling. Presidente nga giluwas sa Ginoo, gitawag ka sa Ginoo, gipahiluna ka, ani nga ministry. God has a purpose with you.
Oh,
and God called you because gibago ka sa Ginoo na ay bago nga buluhaton gihatag sa Ginoo imo. And you should grab that opportunity.
Amen.
Amen? And kinahanglan masabtan nato ang pagkaginoo ni Jesus sa atong kinabuhi because we will if we were doing the ministry, we will doing the will of God, then sakto maka solid Deo gloria. Glory to God alone.
Amen.
Amen. Okay, my encouragement of my message is this, to encourage each believer to submit to the Lordship of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Maybe some of you, say, ban siguro sa inyo, sayon si Exabton, Jesus is Lord. Is, mangutan ako karon, is Jesus is Lord on Monday?
Amen.
Is Jesus Christ is Lord, gamayarag amen, dere, on Tuesday? Ah, tinod ba ka na? God sees your heart. God sees your heart. Okay. Is God, if Jesus, is Jesus Christ is Lord over your business? Is my businessman there? If, is God, is Jesus Christ is Lord over your family?
Amen.
Amen.
We need to understand that. We need to submit on the Lordship of Jesus Christ. Walay lain, kung dili na to isadmitar atong kaugalingon sa pagkaginoo sa ni Jesus Kristo, and then, ebulong, the tendency is this, dali kita madala sa kalibutan. You know what? Kung gibuhat sa Ginoo ang iyang buluhaton, ang kaaway po gibuhat 24/7, ang tanayang buluhaton para disturbuhon ta. Satan is working right now. Kung lang tao na ito karon sa social media, sa asa nga, sa television, unsa gyud na promote ro wickedness, immorality, pride. Gina-exalt ni Satan ang mga dautan. Usay dili ta makabantay niya na. Kinahanglan, ma-feel ta. Kinahanglan si Jesus Christ, tinuod nga Lord sa itong kinabuhi. The Spirit, the Holy Spirit is filled with us. And then we can discern what is holy and what is not holy. What is for God and what is for the world. I will give you one testimony of my life. When I was working in Cebu before, I was in technical support in the company. Nami seminar na gibuhat sa Marriott Hotel. If you would know Marriott Hotel, I've been there for a couple of seminars that we had. Pag-abot na ako, busy kayo for registration. Dito ko sa lobby sa hotel, the sixth floor, dito man naman. Dayon, God, nagpahulay ko kay duot makay, di ko ganag crowded. Ato ko sa lobby, naglanta ko sa mga building. And somehow the Lord speak to me, the Holy Spirit speak to me at that time, I believe. Tignan ko niya. Lantawa, Eric. Lantawa, anong palibot ni mo? Hatagi ko butang, that is the value is eternal. Lanta ko, ang building di man eternal. Ang kining mga sakinan, dili eternal. And then I go, Lord, what my eternal, Lord? See? Wala kayo makita. Because ako ray maghatag ni mo eternal life.
Hallelujah.
Ngayon siya nga, tanan, anong kalibutan na will pass away.
Amen.
But I will be remain. So muna, nga, kinahanglan nato masabtan ang pagka-lordship ni Jesus Christ sa itong kinabuhi. Amen ba?
Amen.
Because mo na gisulti sa Biblia, every tongue will acknowledge, dili lang taman sa baba, and the way how we live. Pero kebalo mang Ginoo na tayong mga struggled. That is why the Holy Spirit was given to us.
Amen.
If the Holy Spirit is not in us, we cannot overcome sin. I tell you.
Amen.
We are in the battle dili na sa gawas, but we are in the battle on ourselves. We need the Holy Spirit. We need the power of the Holy Spirit. We need to submit sa Holy Spirit in order kanang mga contamination sa kalibutan ato mga kinaiya through the sinful nature that we had masanctify ta.
Amen.
Because one of the work of the Holy Spirit is sanctification. Ginasanctify ta. Para makita sa imong kinabuhi nga lahi na siya. Si Kristo makita.
Amen.
Because you gipa sigarbo nimo si Kristo sa kinabuhi. Because ang tinuod, bago naman ta.
Amen.
Ang karaan, wala na.
Amen.
Kung bago na ta, naray bago nga mission, purpose, ngayatag sa Ginoo sa itong kinabuhi.
Amen.
Amen.